I thought we would start today with a little bit of math for you. We have in this graduated cylinder 50 milliliters of water, and in this one we have another 50 milliliters of water. And the question is, how many milliliters of water will we end up with if we pour the two of them together? Well, there you have it, folks. 50 mils of water and 50 mils of water equals 100 mils of water. Okay, so here we go again. We have 50 milliliters of water, but this time we have 50 milliliters of ethanol. And we're going to pour the two together and see if we wind up with that magic 100 once again. It, folks, only 97 milliliters. So 50 mils of water, 50 mils of ethanol equals 97 milliliters of a water ethanol mix. How does that work? Well, that's what we're gonna find out. Okay, so what just happened here is that water bonds differently than ethanol does. So when water packs in, it can't pack in quite as closely. When we pour the ethanol in, the ethanol is able to go in between those water molecules and takes up less space. So we don't get the same amount of volume as you would expect. What I mean when I say that water bonds differently than ethanol is that the atoms within each molecule form a different kind of bond with one another. Water forms what we call a polar covalent bond, which means that you don't share those electrons equally. So we get a different charge. Now, water, because it can't pack in quite as closely, it also has different properties. Adhesive means that water molecules or water droplets want to stick to things. They want to adhere to another surface. Cohesiveness means that they want to stick to one another. So they form these bonds that they stick to one another and they stick to other things. And in this next experiment, we're going to see exactly what that means. Okay, so we're going to try out a little experiment today using water and ethanol. What we need is a screen, just a regular screen like you would find on your screen door, and an elastic. So we'll push the ethanol to the side and we'll start off with the water. Now, just place the screen over top. Put the elastic on to hold it down. And just like a regular screen, water can pass through it. Okay, if you'll notice that you still have a little bit of water that sticks to the top of the screen, and that's the adhesive cohesive properties that we talked about a little bit earlier. Now, watch what happens as we dump it. We turn it upside down. As soon as the jar becomes vertical, no more water can escape through the screen. And that's because water adheres to the screen and coheres to itself. And there's less air in the jar than there is around the room, so the air pressure actually holds it up. As soon as we tip it, we break those properties, we break that seal that it's created, and the water is allowed to freely flow out of the jar. Okay, so we just tried that with water. Now we're gonna try it with ethanol. This is 95% ethanol, so very little water content, and shouldn't have those adhesive cohesive properties because ethanol is not a polar molecule. So we'll put the screen on, just like we did before. Try to pour a little bit of ethanol through. You can see it freely flows into the jar. And we'll get a good grip on this jar. And one, two, three. As you can see, the screen can't hold it in because ethanol is not a polar molecule.